Srinivasa Ramanujan Iyengar was born on 22nd December 1887 in Erode, Tamil Nadu, in a poor Brahmin family. His father, K. Srinivasa Iyengar, was a clerk in a saree shop. His mother, Komratammal, was a housewife who used to sing at a local temple. His wife, S. Janaki Ammal. They lived in Sarangapani Street in a traditional home in the town of Kumbakonam. The family house is now a museum. On 1st October 1892, Ramanujan was enrolled at the local Kangayan Primary School. At school, he performed very well in all examinations and entered Town Higher Secondary School, where he encountered formal mathematics for the first time.
By the age of 10, Ramanujan had gained such an outstanding mathematical ability that he was awarded a scholarship to the Kumbakonam Town School. He had an insatiable curiosity for all things mathematical and neglected his other subjects at school. When he completed his education in Town Higher Secondary School, he was awarded K. Ranganatha Rao Prize for Mathematics.
He demonstrated unusual mathematical skills at school, winning accolades and awards. At the age of 17, Ramanujan conducted his own mathematical research on Bernoulli numbers and the Euler-Mascarenhi constant. He received scholarship to study at Government Arts College in Kumbakonam, but lost it when he failed his non-mathematical coursework. Then he joined another college to pursue independent mathematical research, working as a clerk in the Accountant General's office at the Madras Port Trust to support himself.
He sent samples of his theorems to the Cambridge University enclosed in a letter, which reads thus:
"Dear sir, I beg to introduce myself to you as a clerk in the Accounts Department of the Port Trust office at Madras on a salary of only £20 per annum. And now about 23 years of age, I have had no university education, but I have undergone the usual school course. After leaving school, I have made a special study of divergent series in general, and the results I got are termed by the local mathematicians as startling. I would request you to go through the enclosed papers. If you are convinced that there is anything of value, I would like to have my theorems published. Being inexperienced, I would highly value any advice you give me. Requesting to be excused for the trouble I gave you, yours very sincerely, S. Ramanujan."
Ramanujan's letter reached London. The recipient of the letter was G.H. Hardy, together with his collaborator J.E. Littlewood at the Trinity College, Cambridge. It seemed essential to Hardy and Littlewood that Ramanujan be brought to Cambridge, where they could introduce him to modern mathematics and help him to develop his true potential.
By chance, another Trinity mathematician, E.H. Neville, was going to Madras to deliver a series of lectures. Hardy requested Neville to contact Ramanujan and invite him to England. In Madras, Neville found that Ramanujan was married to a 14-year-old girl called Janaki Ammal.
Many years later, at the age of 84, when she was interviewed, she said this about him:
"All I can tell you is that day and night he worked down sums. He didn't do anything else. He wasn't interested in anything else. Just sums. He wouldn't stop work even to eat. We had to make rice balls to him and place in the palm of his hand. Isn't that extraordinary?"
Ramanujan and his family were Brahmins, poor but extremely orthodox in matters of religion. It seemed out of question for him to leave India by crossing the sea to another land, as a Brahmin who crosses the sea loses his caste and becomes polluted in the eyes of his own community.
His family told him not to go, but he said his goddess Namagiri told him to go. I asked if I could go with him, but he told me I was too young. Before he left for London, he had long hair. Then he cut his hair and dressed in different clothes. You can see his photo, how he looked.
On March 17, 1914, Ramanujan left for England. He was 26 years old. He arrived in London on 14th April. Ramanujan soon began his work with Hardy and Littlewood. Hardy and Ramanujan began to take a look at Ramanujan's notebooks. Ramanujan left a deep impression on Hardy and Littlewood. Ramanujan spent nearly 5 years in Cambridge collaborating with Hardy and Littlewood and published a part of his findings there. He became a Fellow of Royal Society and a Fellow of Trinity College, Cambridge.
He had health problems in England due to insufficient nutritional food. He was diagnosed with tuberculosis and a severe vitamin deficiency.
Ramanujan returned to Kumbakonam, Madras Presidency in 1919 and died soon after at the age of 32.
During his short lifespan, Ramanujan independently compiled nearly 3,900 results, although a small number of these results were actually false and some were already known. But most of his claims have now been proven correct. He stated results that were both original and highly unconventional, such as Ramanujan prime and Ramanujan theta function, and these have inspired a vast number of further researchers. However, some of his major discoveries have been rather slow to enter the mathematical mainstream.
Ramanujan has contributed a lot to the field of mathematics in his short lifetime, such as magic square, sum of series, combinational analysis, polynomials, number theory, analogues of gamma functions, continued fractions, and many more.
When we think of partitioning a number, what we are talking about is breaking it into sum of other numbers. For example, 10 is 6 plus 4. Take for example the number 7. 7, 6 plus 1, 5 plus 2, 5 plus 1 plus 1, 4 plus 3, 4 plus 2, and so on. So, if we count up all sums that we made, here we see that the total number is 15. Generally, this is denoted by the shorthand P of 7 equals 15. Ramanujan wanted to develop the formula to calculate the number of partition of any number, no matter how large. One of Ramanujan's great mathematical achievements was the prime number theorem. This theorem gave a formula for approximating how many primes there were up to any particular number we want, no matter how large it is. Although it was a tremendous achievement, it is an approximate solution. This was a revolution and a surprising achievement.
Srinivasa Ramanujan and his magic square. This square looks like any other normal magic square, but this is formed by great mathematician of our country, Srinivasa Ramanujan. Sum of numbers of any row is 139. Sum of numbers of any column is also 139. Sum of numbers of any diagonal is also 139.
Sum of corner numbers is also 139.
Sum of identical colored boxes is also 139.
Look at these central squares.
Can you try these combinations? Do you know date of birth of Srinivasa Ramanujan? get the first room. It is 22nd December 1887.
Littlewood once said,
"Every positive integer was one of Ramanujan's friends. He was so involved with numbers."
As told by Hardy,
"I remember once going to see him when he was lying ill in his apartment. I had written in a taxi cab number 1729 and remarked that the number 1729 seemed to be a rather dull one, that I hoped it was not an unfavorable omen."
Ramanujan replied,
"No, Hardy, it is a very interesting number. It is the smallest number expressible as the sum of two cubes in two different ways."
Generalization of this idea has created the notion of taxi cab numbers.
Hardy arranged for Ramanujan's mathematical papers to be edited and published as a lasting memorial to this mathematical genius.
Some eminent personalities have expressed their thoughts about Ramanujan.
He once said, "An equation has no meaning for me unless it expresses a thought of God. A completely self-made individual with almost no mathematical training." And today he is revered as one of the greatest mathematical geniuses of the 20th century.
Ramanujan had a passion, but Ramanujan had a passion for mathematics. He concentrated on work, and the whole world came to him.
Would you believe me if I told you that this is the house of Ramanujan?
One day at school, Ramanujan's teacher pointed out that anything divided by itself is one. Take four fruits, divide it among four people, you get one. Each one will get one. Divide 1,000 fruits among 1,000 people, each one will get one. Ramanujan suddenly came up with a nice question. If you divide no fruits among no people, will still each get one? I mean, like zero, when it divided by zero, will the answer still be one?
Ramanujan lost everything he had. Scholarship in school, work as a tutor. But he had everything. Because between him and his notebooks, which were crammed with theorems, he had everything he needed to carry on his day-to-day life. And these notebooks of his grew thicker and thicker with each passing week. This was also Ramanujan, trying to establish himself without his knowledge.
He was simply a prophet that had the message, the word encoded in his chromosomes, in his genes.
Ramanujan's belief was purely about numbers and their mathematical relationships, which provided him with clues showing him how the universe fits together, and every new theorem was a newborn entity for him.
Ramanujan was trying to comprehend the infinite reality around him and trying to point out that our existence is nothing but a human life is nothing but a zero.
I take Ramanujan as a person whose creation was due to some supreme entity.
January 16th, 1930. Ramanujan writes a letter to another senior Cambridge mathematician, G.H. Hardy.
So on March 17th, 1914, the S.S. Srinivasa slipped slowly away into the tropical waters of the Bay of Bengal. Destination? England. Ramanujan would make his way across the great courts of Trinity College with some difficulty wearing his slippers. English were having some problem pronouncing his name correctly. And they would say, Ramanujan.
Ramanujan's life should be a role model for all young children pursuing any aspect of study.
Mathematics, the highest plane, was the enchanting to these two brains, to these great brains.
He believed that God and infinity were the same thing, with zero not there.
The Man Who Knew Infinity, A Life of the Genius Ramanujan, is a biography written by Robert Kenigal in 1991. The book gives a detailed account of his upbringing in India, his mathematical achievements, and his mathematical collaboration with the English mathematician G.H. Hardy. The book also reviews the life of Hardy and the academic culture of Cambridge University during the early 20th century.
The Ramanujan Journal, an international publication, was launched to publish work in all areas of mathematics, influenced by his work. By the end of November 1918, Hardy wrote in letter,
"He will return to India with great scientific standing and reputation such as no Indian has ventured before, and I am confident that India will regard him as the treasure he is. His natural simplicity and modesty has later been affected in the least by the success. Indeed, all that is wanted is to get him to realize that he is really a success."
In December 2011, in recognition of his contribution to mathematics, the Government of India declared that Ramanujan birthday, that is 22nd of December, should be celebrated every year as National Mathematics Day.